Man, I rarely ever listen to any of you because I'm always like, no, I got the best ideas. That's why I'm the king of DIY and you're the viewer, but I am so wrong right now. The day everybody's been waiting for, adding the fish to the 2,000-gallon aquarium. If you guys don't remember, I told you guys I kind of want to do community fish, maybe some small fish, or maybe we do something specialized with archer fish. I couldn't finish the word archer fish, and you guys swarmed me and overwhelmed me with the idea of having such a specialized hunter in the aquarium that has the ability to shoot water out of its mouth, knock down insects, flies, whatever it is, from maybe climbing on the tree or the branches or the waterfall, whatever the case might be. You guys absolutely loved that idea. Problem was, they're not that easy to find, but I did. Now these guys are still in quarantine, but we were able to pick up just shy of 30 of them. This is the clouded archer fish. Out of the 10 recognized species of archer fish, only 2 to 3 of them are actually brackish water fish. The rest are freshwater, including these guys. Now with that said, those guys can be slowly converted to brackish water, but they'll do just fine in fresh or brackish. If you're not familiar with brackish, we have freshwater, we have saltwater. In between is brackish, basically estuaries, lagoons, things like that where the ocean kind of meets fresh water. It mixes up, it comes almost like 50-50. That's brackish water. And in saying that, I do actually understand the reason why a lot of people were getting upset that these guys are brackish. Not a lot of information out there on brackish water fish, and probably because a lot of people aren't interested because they're not really colorful fish and or perceived to be that interesting, but they're absolutely fascinating. With that said, quarantine went great. These guys are eating well and doing well, haven't had any losses, so I'm pretty confident that they'll do okay in here. It is a much bigger aquarium though, and these guys are relatively small, so it's not gonna look that great. A lot of you guys said that before where the 2000 looked empty, and because we only had a few rays, arowana, maybe a tiny little giant gourami. Now the arowana is almost, it's a little more than 2 feet long. Susan the giant gourami is definitely, I don't know, like 18 inches. And then the rays themselves are absolute beasts. Stocking in this tank temporarily changed. I had to remove a lot of the smaller guys because the rays are starting to show signs of breeding. I'm hoping one day I can move Susan to this tank and just have the arowana and these three black stingrays. I think I might even give Jeff these two pearl stingrays for his massive tank. This is really tough to get big rays in, and I've always just want to go back to my trio and an Asian arowana because these ones are the ones that are breeding anyway. So with that said, yeah, those archer fish are tiny, maybe 2.5 inches, something like that, but they have the potential to get to 8 to 12 inches, and 30 of them in there, absolutely incredible. We'll just have to be patient and grow them out. But once we do, oh boy, I think it's gonna be pretty incredible. Let's put them in.
Got them.
Do they ever look boring from above? Those are fat bellies though. I have a feeling these guys will grow quickly. I'm not sure how fast they grow or if they're slow growers or not, but I guess time will find out. Let's get them in the tank.
You guys ready?
All right. Here we go. You can see them all in the back here. Here they come. What's wrong, guys? The tank too big? Oh, they never look ridiculous. Oh man, but man, this is the perfect tank for them. I don't know if you guys can see what I see. I'm not a good camera guy, even though I've been holding the camera and filming for 12 years. This is amazing. These are the perfect fish. Guys, man, I rarely ever listen to any of you because I'm always like, no, I got the best ideas. That's why I'm the king of DIY and you're the viewer, but I am so wrong right now. Wow. What a good job, guys. You did a good job. And I don't want to spoil it, but maybe I should start listening to you guys more often. Oh, man, that's just a camera. I'll get it out. Yeah, many of you guys actually ask me, if I ever drop anything or need to do anything inside the tank, how do I do it? I've had big tanks for a long time, and I've learned to get the right pieces of equipment to help me, you know, get things out. I got massive nets, these claw things, in order to clean the glass of the tank. I've shown you guys this before. Here's a shower scrubber. This thing, like, literally just comes off, non-toxic, non-abrasive. Anyways, I'll move the fish.
Yeah, so these guys aren't necessarily a natural schooling fish, so they're not all clumped up together. However, this is an absolutely enormous aquarium in comparison to what they're used to, so they're just exploring it right now. We'll see what they do over time. Will they be able to find the food easily? Yeah, I'm just going to feed directly in the center of the tank. They'll see it coming down, and they'll go after it. I've already fed them today, so I'm not going to go ahead and feed them again. But yeah, we've got a few back here. They're just all throughout the tank. They are surface skimmers though, so I'm thinking we need some bottom dwellers, whether we do Corydora or maybe some fancy plecos. I don't know. Let me know in the comment section below. It's all looking absolutely phenomenal, isn't it? Just gorgeous. Absolutely beautiful. Now, because I cycled the tank, I am producing nitrates in the tank, which is helping with growing some algae. It is growing a little bit on the substrate, but I also wanted to start covering the tree and the rock, so a lot of things start just looking far more natural. And of course, the waterfall over time, that will also accumulate algae and bacteria, and it will become like a natural biological waterfall. I need to start paying more closer attention to the pothos, because as you can see, it's actually growing quite well now. Maybe I'll trim some off and keep replanting it. I would love to have all natural foliage. I'm testing to see where pothos will grow with just this light above it. And right now, this one's doing really well. So if it does well there, then I assume it might do well over here. And we could just have vines everywhere. But give it time. I need more time. And we both need to have some patience.
Mostly me, but it would help if you did too. That was far more satisfying and a much better idea than I thought it was actually going to be. And I think that you guys probably think so as well. With that said, this is gonna be a really interesting tank to follow. I think that over the next 6 months is gonna be incredibly fascinating. Just seeing the plants grow, the fish get bigger and bigger, but leaves the question of what should we do for bottom dwellers and or maybe a mid swimmer. Perhaps if these guys put on some size, I would love to move Susan over to it. I think she would be absolutely phenomenal in that tank, especially since they have like similar body types. She would be like the giant mother, and they would be all, I don't know. Let me know what you guys think in the comment section below. If you enjoyed this video, make sure you give it a thumbs up. Subscribe if you haven't already. I do these videos, and I have been for over 12 years. If you wanna support this channel, go ahead and get one of my shirts. Link is in the description, as well as a copy to my book. I'm really bad at these outros.